Hey everyone, thanks for joining us again. Today I want to talk about watchlists and how you can use them as the hub of all your analysis in Optuma. They're very powerful. I mean, we can use them in quite a simple way of just having a list of tickers and then updating charts that are next to the watchlist. But there's some really powerful things we can do as well. So let's jump in and let's create a new watchlist. So we'll go up to the new menu and you'll see watchlists there. And we've just got an empty watch list. Now I can come along here and I can say, right, let's just go and add some tickers. So let me just think of some names that I can and we'll get these in. Now, what we can do with this is we can add some columns quickly. So let's just add in the name. And so I just hit that plus sign and search for name. And I'm just going to go off the standard fields. Now the standard columns there that we can add, these are all just ones that are included with the Optuma data set. So they're data that we provide. Everybody should have that. If you subscribe to the fundamental, you will have that as well. But what I want to add is the exchange. So I know where they're coming from. And this is really, we call it exchange, but it's really the data group in Optuma that we're listing there. So we can see those ones. So you can see that we've got that. We can double click on one, have a chart next to it. And we've already talked about this when we talked about layouts, how you can update chart layouts, etc. What we've got here is what I would call a custom watch list. And that means that I'm adding the securities as I go. But what I can do is say, right, well, this custom list, it may actually represent my portfolio. And maybe I want to use that in a scan like we've shown scanning before. Well, then what I can do is say, let's just send this to a manual list. So we'll come in here, we'll go to manual list and we'll say, I want this list of tickers to be included in a new manual list. And here it is, it's already filled the list in and I've just got to give it a name. And so I'm just going to call it my portfolio. Hit enter and now that's saved. Now, anywhere in Optuma where I've used a symbol list in the past, scanning, back testing, signal testing, etc., I now have this manual list and I can use this. Just as an aside, I can come in here. So for instance, let's just say I want to update that list. I can come through here to the open symbol lists and anytime I can just come and add codes or remove codes, etc., from this manual list. So I've got a lot of control over that. That's great. And again, very handy, but sometimes depending on the way that you work, maybe it's more that you have a coverage and there's a allocation of securities that you need to analyze on a regular basis. And so what we can do instead of having this manual list is we can set up a list which is linked to one of the symbol lists. So again, what we come down to on the watch list, we're linked to list is what we want to choose. Now, Optuma's warning me, if I go ahead, I'm going to clear out all of these saved securities that I have here. That's fine. We'll just say yes to that. And then what I can do is say list to use. Now, I can come along here and say, right, let's go and find the North American lists and we're going to do the NASDAQ 100. So select that. And now I've got my list set up with the 100 stocks that are in the NASDAQ 100, we can see. And then again, I can just click on them, update them, etc., however I like. Now, I can link, I can unlink. If I unlink now, those would be there. I could add and remove. So it's a good way, again, of just seeding the watch list, and then you can work with it from that point. Other columns that we could add, there's a couple of unique ones in Optuma, which are worth just having a look at. So we can come along here. We've got the chart preview, which is a nice little image of the chart here that you can use. You know, we've got the yearly range as well, which is another interesting one. Basically, that's telling us if we were to consider the 52-week high and the 52-week low, where is the price currently? So this would be the high. So we'd see here AMD is up near their yearly high. And you can see that when we look at the chart preview. But we've got Amgen here, which is down near their yearly low. So a couple little unique columns that you can throw in there. Now, a very interesting thing as well is that this is based on daily data. Now, if I was to do a script, and we've talked about scripting before, so let's just quickly throw a script in here and say, I want to know on these stocks whether the close has, let's just say is above. So we'll do this as a filter. Is above a moving average, and we're going to make that 20 period, and I want it to be an exponential moving average, and hit apply to that. And you can see that I've got true and false. Now I really should name that. So I'm going to right click on the column and I'm going to say close above MA. And so I've got my column labeled that way. So I've got this script here, I've got these charts, they're all being calculated on daily data. If I want to change that, I can just go to the properties of the watch list and you'll see here that I've got 1 day. I can change that to 1 week. And you'll see all these charts, everything updates, not so much the yearly range because that's not going to change too much based on time frame, but the chart preview did, and you would have seen the script column that we put in obviously is different now that we're looking at that, because instead of being on 20 days, it's on 20 weeks. So you've got that control as well. Remember that that's available to you. One last thing that I want to put in here, let's just clear a couple of these things away, just give us a bit of room, is we do have fundamental data available as well. So if you subscribe to one of the fundamental data packs, you'll see all of these available, and there is a lot that you can add in here. So let's just say, let me grab one of the TTM. So earnings per share on a trailing 12-month period, we can select that and we see what those values are for each of those securities as well. So you can link fundamentally. Now, if you're using the Enterprise Edition and you were working with Bloomberg, you can bring in all Bloomberg fields. So anything that's in the FLDS command section, all of those can be brought into this watch list as well. So if you need help with that, let us know. Now, one of the things we can do, you can see that, for instance, we have this filter of close greater than moving average. Now, I could click on that and I could sort it like that. You know, sometimes there are values that maybe I want to put in groups. And so, again, we can sort this, but maybe I'm only after the top 10% on EPS. They're the ones that are interesting to me. Probably should do yield and not just raw dollars. But nevertheless, what I can do is come in here and I can say, right, I want to group this column and I want to group them. I can do by quartile, I can do by decile, so 10 groups, or a custom number of bins as well. But let's just do, I want to group by decile. And so now we've got this. Let me change the order. So what I've got here is the earnings per share, and I've got the first decile, the second decile, etc. And maybe I'm not interested in the others, so I can close all of these up and we can see them here. Now, another interesting thing we can do with watch lists is this gray space here. I can right click and say, I want a summary here. So I want the summary, let's just say the average. And now all of those have been calculating the average for the elements that are in that group. So again, very powerful, the types of things you can do. Now, let's just say that we've set this up and we're like, this is great. I want to use this layout all the time on my watch list. Well, like we have chart layouts and we've already talked about those, we can actually have a watch list layout as well. And I'm just going to call it my WL layout, but you can give it any name that you like. Just get rid of that character. And there we go. That's now saved. And so if I went to a brand new watch list, actually, the way that I always open watch lists is I right click here and I just go, give me a watch list. And I can say, right, let's link this one to a list. And we're going to link it to the, well, I won't do the Bloomberg one. Let me just do the ASX 50. And then I can come along and say, right, let's use my watch list layout. And, oh, there we go. Earnings per share, I don't have that number there. I'm obviously not bringing in the fundamental data, so there's only one group there. But nevertheless, you can see how that layout can be used on different lists once I saved it. And I can swap between layouts. So maybe I have a layout of what's in my portfolio and versus a layout for when I'm looking at my coverage and the securities that are candidates to go in my portfolio. So again, very flexible with the way that you can use all of that as well. One thing to note though, the grouping feature is only in the enterprise and professional editions of Optuma. So you may not have that depending on which edition you have. Another feature in the enterprise version is that we have grouping and we can group by multiple columns. So at the moment we're grouping by EPS, which obviously isn't doing much now because we've only got one value, but I could also group by any other column or any other data field that isn't even on the watch list. So I may want to group by, let's just say, let me just do one of the other TTM fields. So maybe yield. Well, again, actually, that's not going to work because I don't have that field either. But you get the idea that we can actually group by multiple levels in the enterprise and professional editions of Optuma. So one last thing we want to do is come back here and let's just say again, I've got this decile of securities, and maybe what I want to do with this is say, I want to open these, and you can see that there are all these options. So just like we had at the top here, that I could open this list as, and it will be all the securities in the watch list. When I do have groups like this, I can say, let's just open them as an RIG. And there is an RIG with those securities being added, showing us the leading quadrant, those that are lagging on a relative basis, etc. So great for portfolio allocation. As we do that sort of work. One final one just to show again, I can come along here and say, right, let's open this as watch tiles. So watch tiles, very similar to watch list, except for we've got that mini chart. We can add some securities to these as well. So we've got our scripts here and we can say, right, let's just add in a moving average. So this will be just a standard 5-period, and you can see that all those charts now have that, and we can add them and we can sort and we can group. And if you've got real-time data coming in, all of these tiles will shuffle as the based on the ordering and the data that comes in as well. So hope that's been of interest. Watch lists, as I said, are very powerful. They allow you to do so much, and they, as I said, they become that hub that all of your analysis can be based on. So I hope that's been beneficial. Thank you.